What if, before going on the mission to hunt the Loki variant Sylvie, Mobius took Loki on another mission, for a trial come training? And what if something goes sideways there? Dear members of the fandom family, welcome to the madness of Fandomverse. Today's story is Farewell, written by the fanfiction writer who goes by the name Sonrox, and narrated by yours truly, Sudeshna Ghosh. Hope you all like it. Let's dive in. Mobius and Loki were on a mission undercover to make Loki go through a training before sending him to hunt down the variant of Loki that Mobius had told him about. Remember, low profile, don't talk to anyone, and don't draw attention to yourself. Got it? Mobius asked, and Loki just nodded. They were in a jail in 2016, hunting a variant of Ant-Man, who after getting his suit became a criminal for a while, committed a lot of robberies until a couple of members of the Avengers caught him and sent him to a common jail. Since without his suit, Scott Lang was just as dangerous as any convicted man. B-15, status, Mobius said into a radio. In position, I'm at your 9. Mobius turned to control room on the other side of the cell block and saw C-20, who nodded at him and he nodded back. Everything was ready. The plan was for Loki and Mobius to start a fight with the variant, and after fighting for too long, B-15 and C-20 have to intervene and forced them to separate. Put them in isolation, and when they all are out of sight of the other guards and the prisoners, they would open a portal to return to TVA. Simple. Right? After exploring the prison a bit, they found Scott on a bench surrounded by other prisoners. Okay, we will have to wait for the variant to be alone. What? Why? He is right there, and he is with friends. If we fight him, his friends will fight us, and things will get complicated. We have to wait. Loki reluctantly agreed, and both the agents sat on a bench where they could keep an eye on the variant. But sooner rather than later, Loki was bored and looked around at the other inmates until he saw a small group of prisoners with sharp plastic spoons and forks. Hey, he called them, and they turned. What are you going to do with those? We want to cause a riot to escape, but we don't know how, said one of the prisoners, and Mobius heard him. A riot? Please, everyone knows how to start a riot. You just have to fight someone while you yell, riot. Mobius thought aloud. Really? Asked one of the convicts. Let's try that, said another, and immediately hit the guy who was closest to him and fell onto the ground, and then shouted, riot. Several prisoners who listened asked, riot? One of the prisoners started, and then another, and then another, and before anyone could do anything, all convicts started attacking the guards and fighting among themselves. Between all of this chaos, blood began to flow. Mobius was looking for the variant they were hunting or any members of his team, but he could not find any one of them anywhere. He walked past a table where a prisoner held another prisoner to the table while he spilled alcohol on his face. No, please don't. I swear it was not me, he begged after spitting out a mouthful of alcohol. No one to run, Villa. The other prisoners threatened him. He took out a lighter and a newspaper, set the paper on fire and threw it at him. At an instant, his entire body was covered in flames and he broke into run as he screamed for help. He almost caught Mobius unintentionally, but he reacted in time and dodged him. Villa continued to run on fire until he hit a wall and ended up rolling over his body until death. By the time Mobius found the variant, it was too late, and the variant was fighting the biggest, strongest guy in the prison, and before Mobius could do anything, the giant prisoner lifted the variant over his head and slammed onto the ground before stomping him with his feet. Any hopes that the variant might still be alive was dashed when Mobius saw the blood trickling from his skull at the warning spit. Ravonna is going to kill me, he murmured. Later, Mobius, Loki, and the other agents had returned to TVA, and the first two were in Ravonna's office. What was I thinking? Mobius said to himself. What were you thinking, Mobius? Ravonna exclaimed. 15 guards wounded and 3 dead to get you, B-15, C-20, and this variant of Loki out of there, she said, pointing at Loki for a moment before letting out a big sigh. It is a miracle that the guardians did not prune you. I know. I'm sorry. I really don't know what happened to me. The variant was there in a moment and he was just poof. He disappeared. I do not know what happened. I do not know if it was the coffee I had in this morning or I slept badly. I don't know. The truth is that the two continued arguing while Loki just watched silently with a poker face. During his entire life, he had seen dozens of arguments like this, and he knew they almost never ended well, unless something else happens. Someone is going to have to answer for the failure of the mission and the gods. If you allow me, Loki intervened. What? They both yelled at the same time. I just wanted to say that what happened in the prison is my fault. I'm sorry. Loki, what are you? Mobius started, but was quickly interrupted by Ravonna. Huh, I should have known that. I knew. It was a bad idea. I should have said no from the beginning, Ravonna complained, rambling with her words. What are you doing? Mobius whispered to him. Trust me, Loki whispered back and winked at Mobius and turned back to Ravonna. When clearly I should have allowed it, do you have something to say in your defense? Ravonna asked. Loki glanced at Mobius over his shoulder for a moment in discomfort before replying, rookie mistake, and smiled. Listen to him for a moment, Ravonna, Mobius continued. What Loki had said, that it was only a training mission after all. Yes, and if that is what is happening in a training mission, I don't want to imagine what will happen when you hunt the Loki variant. Yes, but remember that whenever I failed you, right after I managed to accomplish the mission, I promise that this time will not be an exception. When you count on me, there will never be an exception. After that, the three of them were silent for several minutes. The only sound in the room was Ravonna's fingers tapping on her desk insistently. They continued like this until Ravonna let out a great sigh, without exceptions. You don't know how much I thank you. Do not make the same mistake again, Ravonna interrupted. Of course, Ravonna. The two of them nodded their heads and Mobius and Loki left the office. And then it was Mobius's turn to let out a sigh. I think you dodged a big bullet, Loki joked. Why did you do that? You are welcome, by the way. Loki smiled again. Don't you play with me. I know you are not the kind of people who would do something for others just because. Well, if you already know the answer, why would you ask? Spit it out at once. What do you want? A tempad. No, I have not even told you where I want to go. And I don't need to. I'm not giving you a tempad. You cannot go back to your timeline. I don't want to go back to my timeline. I just need to see something. No. Impossible. Mobius shook his head numerous times. Are you serious? Yes. For a moment, Loki looked at him like a staring contest. And seeing that Mobius had no intention of losing, he turned and started walking towards Ravonna's office. If that's your decision, I suppose Ravonna would not mind finding out what really happened on the mission, Loki said and turned towards Ravonna's office. No, wait. He stopped him. Okay, you win. I'll let you use the tempad. And just one time. I'm glad to hear that. With the condition that I go with you. And you don't cause any Nexus event. Understood? Actually, I need to go to two places. No, that was not part of the deal. Ravonna, would you stop doing that? He shuts Loki up by covering his mouth and hiding in the hallway before Ravonna peeked out of her office door. They both went to a time theater to continue whatever this was. Fine, two places. Nothing more. Where do you want to go? Loki smiled again at that question. A portal opened in a living room of a house and Mobius and Loki, with a small box in his hand, emerged from it. Upon entering, the first thing they noticed was the intense smell of beer. Mobius's first reaction was to open a window, but Loki, noticing this, stopped him on the spot. Don't do it. We can't let him know that we are here. Who? You did not tell me where we are. Do you really care so much to know? Loki resisted Mobius. I care to know what danger we are posing by simply being here. We will be leaving soon if you have too much trouble, your majesty. He said the last part in a mocking tone. He set the box he carried with him on the living room's table, delicately and fearfully, as if the smallest wrong move would ruin everything. Loki wanted to see more of the house he was in, but an approaching voice forced Loki and Mobius to hide in the room. Are you sure you want to go with those guys? They heard a woman. Instantly, they hid in one of the rooms. Moments later, they heard the door opening. Then they heard another voice. It's the best for everyone. And for me too. I was never too fond of being a king, if I'm honest. And you can do a great job, really. Inside the room they were hiding in, Mobius and Loki started arguing. "It's time to go," he whispered. "No, I want to hear this." And they did. At the same time, Loki analyzed the room. And seeing it carefully, Loki confirmed his suspicions. This was his house. "This place won't be the same without you," Thor. "I know, but I've never been the one to stay in one place for too long. This is the perfect opportunity for me to do something better. You brought half of Asgard back to life, and without counting, half of the bloody universe. That is something big for everyone. You have to learn to give yourself some credit. I have made my decisions, Valkyrie, and I don't want to regret it. If you really are so determined to go, let me go to my place. There is something I would like you to go with." "Sure," Thor accepted. The two time agents heard the door close and Thor was left alone. In an attempt to avoid silence, Thor searched for something to entertain himself with until Valkyrie returned. And very soon, he found the box that Loki left behind. He checked it carefully but found no clue that it could tell him who was it from. Thor opened the box and inside he found a letter. "I told you, brother, the sun would shine on us again. I'm sorry I'm not there to see how it rises with you. I regret not being there when you needed me the most. And I regret all the hardships that I put you through. And mother, and father, and everyone else's. I promise you that I will try to clean the blood that has stained in my hands for years. In the same way that I assured you that the sun would shine on us once more. I assure you, brother, I'll be good for all the times that I never could. I wish that I could be there with you, but the path that I have taken separates me from yours. I hope that with this, you would remember me as you always saw me. Your brother." Thor stood in complete silence the entire time he read the letter, not breathing, not blinking, or moving. With a dead face the entire time. His first thought was that someone was playing a bad joke with him. He carefully and fearfully set the letter aside, then found something else inside the box. He found a necklace with some strange stones, but familiar at the same time. When looking at it a little closer, Thor could appreciate Asgardian ruins carved over the stones. And as if the necklace was calling him, Thor brushed his fingers over the stone and they gave off a blue electric glow. And at that same instant, he knew what it was. It was a necklace made of the remains of Mjolnir. He immediately dropped the necklace and walked away, colliding with the furniture until it hit the wall. After merely processing what was happening, he ran from his house to the street. "Loki, Loki, where are you?" he screamed, turning to every side. He approached every people who were passing through the street and saw each one of them as he had seen a ghost. Well, in a way, he was actually looking for a ghost. "Loki, Loki, please show yourself. Where are you, brother?" Valkyrie saw this and went over to find out what was happening. "Thor, Thor, just calm down. What happened? Tell me." "Loki, I'm so glad to see you here, brother. You are alive." "Thor, calm down. What are you talking about? Loki is dead. You told me yourself." "Please stop your tricks. Please, brother, just come back." Thor grabbed Valkyrie by her shoulders. "I only want you to come back. I don't care what you have done. If you are in trouble, I can help you. Please come back." Meanwhile, inside the house, Loki watched from the window. Mobius joined him, placing his hand on Loki's shoulder. For a moment, Loki thought he was trying to comfort him. And although he knew that was his intention, it was also in a way of telling him to not to do anything stupid. "How did you know where to go?" Mobius asked. Loki, despite of hearing him, took several seconds to answer. "When I saw my life just before father died, he told us to remember this place. He used to say that Asgard was not a place, but the people. And it seems that Thor understood that." The two of them stared through the window as Thor broke apart as Valkyrie tried to calm him down. While Mobius was not looking, Loki summoned a dagger into his hand. his fingers rubbing through the blade of the dagger. His mind wandered between ideas and what would happen if he would follow his instincts. "Ready to go?" Loki did not answer. "Loki," he called a little louder. He awkwardly turned around for a second before answering. "One more minute." Loki interpreted Mobius' silence as an okay. After a while, he no longer saw Thor through the window, but rather his reflection in the window. For a second, he could see Mobius' hand on his shoulder transform into Thanos' hand when he choked his neck. He no longer had a place here. Mobius was forced to pull Loki out of his thoughts. "Come on, we have a variant to hunt." Loki vanished the dagger from his hand and nodded. Mobius opened the portal to TVA and the two of them crossed. What if this was the closest Thor and Loki could ever get? Love to know your thoughts on that. Please share them in the comments. Hope you all like it. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon so that you never miss updates of new fanfictions and much more. You can also suggest and share links to your writings in the comment section for me to share them with our fandom family in my future videos. Soon we will dive into the fandom verse again. Until then, stay well and enjoy the madness of fandom verse.